In this video, we're going to take a look at Assistive Access on the iPad. This is a new interface that Apple created in iOS 17. Basically, what they did is they made the buttons larger and they only contain the core features. It basically makes the iPad easier to use for some people. Let's take a look at this Assistive Access on the iPad. Now, the way that I'm going to do that is just show you first what Assistive Access is, and then we'll take a look at how we set it up and customize it. Let's go over to my iPad and take a look at what Assistive Access is. So this is the interface for Assistive Access. As you can see, we got nice big buttons, and I swipe up to view all of the apps here. Now you're going to see that I do not have all of the apps on my iPad. I have a lot more apps on my iPad. Well, what we can do is we can customize which apps are shown here, and we can customize what some of the features are. As an example, with the camera, it only has photo and video. Well, I can also include selfie photo and selfie video, so it will show the front camera. I turn that off, so Johnny here only has access to those two cameras. With the Photos app, I can select which albums Johnny has access to. So we can set which features for some of these apps. Now, not all of these apps are designed for Assistive Access. We have the core apps here, camera, messages, photos. But when we go over to calendar as an example, you're going to see that it is the standard calendar. So not all apps are designed for this. I do believe that Apple will add more apps as time goes on, but for now, we have just a few basic apps, but it does work nice for some people. You just want to have the core apps in there with some core features, and then you maybe want to add a few games that they can play. You can do that easily with Assistive Access. So now that you know what Assistive Access is, how do you set this up? Well, let's take a look. The first thing we need to do is we need to go over to our Settings app. So I tap on Settings here. And then what we do is we go over to Accessibility. You may have to swipe up here a little bit, but you need to go over to Accessibility. This is an accessibility option. When we go over to Accessibility, down towards the bottom, you're going to see Assistive Access. And again, if you are not using iOS 17 or later, you will not see this. I tap on this, and then from here, I just tap on Setup Assistive Access. There are a number of steps that are involved, so let's go and get started with this and see how this all works. I tap on it, I tap on continue, it tells us what it is here, and then it tells me which account it's going to be tied to, so I'm going to go with Johnny's account here, and now what I'm able to do is change the appearance. So I can have it in rows, which is how I like to do this on the iPhone. You can do this on the iPhone as well, or what we can do is we can have it as a grid. I'm going to leave it as a grid, like what you saw. So now I tap on continue. And then from here, what we do is we select which apps we want to include. We don't have to include all of the apps. So I'm setting this up for John. I want John to be able to access the camera. And from here, I can set what features I want him to use. So let's say he takes photos and he takes videos, but he doesn't take selfies. So I'm going to leave selfies off. He's not going to have access to those features. Tap on continue. Let's go with messages. He needs to access messages, and from here I can select which contacts as well as other features. So I'm just going to go with continue. Well, actually, no, let's take out video selfie and continue. And he's going to access the photos. And I'm going to include the shared albums. And I can select which albums I want him to have access to. And then from here, you're going to see more apps. So basically what we have is two sets of apps. These apps here are optimized for Assistive Access. So these are going to have the bigger buttons. While these apps here are going to be standard apps. They're not redesigned for this Assistive Access. But you can still access them. So if Johnny has a favorite game that he likes to play, you can add that game in here. It's not going to change that game at all. So let's go ahead and add a couple more in here. John wants to access the App Store. I'm going to say allow for Bluetooth. As you can see, we have, I'm not going to allow any photos here. We have a lot of different settings in here. Should he be able to use Face ID? I'm going to say allow. And should the contacts, should it be able to access contacts? And we'll go with access the camera in case there's a QR code. So as you can see that, There are a few different settings depending on which app you choose. We're going to go on to add another one. We're going to go with Bing. Bing should be able to access the camera, fitness and motion, access all of the photos, full access, and the microphone. Sure, John wants to be able to use Siri with it. And I'm going to go with the location, always. Let's go with the calendar and use the location while using the app. And we will go with the clock. Needs to have the clock in there. And let's go with one more. Johnny needs files. And now I've just added those apps. So now what I do is I just tap on continue until I get all the way through here. I do need to enter in a passcode. So I type in the passcode here. Type it in again. It's just a 4-digit passcode. All this passcode does is allow you to enter Assistive Access, and it allows you to exit it. I'm just going to bypass this. I know what my passcode is, but if you want to set up a recovery Apple ID, you could do that as well if it's a cryptic passcode. I'm going to keep it simple. And then I just start using Assistive Access. When I tap on this, what it's going to do, once I type in that passcode, it's going to enter into that Assistive Access. So basically what it does here is a soft reboot. So now we have my Assistive Access interface. Johnny can just tap on camera to take a photo. He can tap on messages to look at his messages. And if he wants to look at his calendar, we can see the entire calendar. It is not designed for Assistive Access. So if we had any games in here, Johnny would be able to play those games in their original interface. Now, if you want to access the settings, how do you do that? Maybe you want to change the Wi-Fi or anything like that. Well, what you need to do is you need to triple-click on the sleep-wake button. So I'm going to triple-click on the sleep-wake button, 1, 2, 3, and you're going to see we have settings and access. So now I just tap on settings, and I type on that code, and now I can change my settings, including the volume or put it into airplane mode. I'm going to go back, and we're going to go back. Now, let's say I wanted to exit this mode. How do I do that? Well, basically, all I have to do is just triple-click on the sleep-wake button again, 1, 2, 3, and you're going to see exit, Assistive Access. I type in the code. It'll do a soft reboot, and then it'll be back to the standard interface. So let's go ahead and do that. It's going to exit this, and then what it's going to do is do a soft reboot, and we're going to be back at my standard interface, the iPad interface. And we can see when I swipe up, I'm back at my standard interface. I want to put it into that Assistive Access mode again. What I need to do is go back into the Settings app. We go over to our Accessibility, and then we go over to Assistive Access, and then we start Assistive Access. It'll go back into that mode. So that's our Assistive Access on the iPad. Again, this was introduced with iPadOS 17, and it basically makes the iPad easy to use for some people. What it does is it makes the buttons larger, as you saw, and the apps only contain the core features. It doesn't include every app. I think that that app library will grow as time goes on, and maybe what Apple will do is open it up to third-party apps as well. So then third-party developers can create a new interface for their apps as well for this Assistive Access. So that's Assistive Access on the iPad.